Hey guys, it's Elizabeth. Welcome back to my channel. And you clicked on this video today because you wanted to learn either more about CASA or see what I got my CASA kids at the Santa shop. So first, I'm gonna show you everything I got them at the Santa shop from the CASA office. And if you don't know what CASA stands for, it stands for Court Appointed Special Advocate, which I am one. I am a CASA for two kids, their brother and sister. The little girl is just turned 9, and then her brother is 15. He is bedbound and nonverbal. I'm gonna show you what I got them from the Santa shop for Christmas. And the Santa shop is a free place for us to go shop for Christmas presents for our kids. And so I went shopping earlier this week, as you saw in the video. And if you didn't see that video, I'll link it up above and you can check out that vlog. Without further ado, let's see what I picked up my kids. So we'll start with the little girl first. Last week was also her birthday, and so at the CASA office, there's a thing also called the hanger closet, where there's toys and clothes and things like that you can grab from, so you don't have to spend your own money, which I think is really cool. For her birthday, I'm gonna wrap this up. She loves unicorns, so I got her a rainbow Sandland art kit. Actually, for her birthday, I might actually put these in there as well. I got her two books, Nancy Drew and the Clue Crew and Dear Dumb Diary. For Christmas, we were allowed to get one toy, either a toy or a board game, and then some clothes. I got her, oh, I thought it was Barbie brand, but it's not. And the rest for her are clothing items. I got her this cute beanie. Got her some fun socks, some gloves. We always need gloves here in Colorado. And then this cute little jeans and sweater outfits. Everything I got for the little girl for her birthday and for Christmas. So let's move on to my boy who's 15. I was told he really likes Paw Patrol. I got him this Paw Patrol book. And then I got him another Paw Patrol thing. It's Light the Way. It has a pop-up book and a 5-sound flashlight. So he loves this kind of thing. Anything that lights up, makes noise, anything interactive, he will really enjoy. And to go along with the Paw Patrol theme, I got him a little Paw Patrol hat that will look cute if they choose to take any pictures. Lastly, on the Paw Patrol train, I got him some Paw Patrol bed sheets that he can use. CASA provided for him some warm socks, so I think these are cute, and I really thought this was really nice of the CASA office, as they gave him a men's grooming kit. Last thing is, they give all the teenagers a gift card, so I think there's an Amazon gift card in there. That's the little haul, and I'm gonna get out my wrapping supplies. I'm gonna start wrapping. Got out all the supplies I need to wrap these presents. So excited to be giving them presents, but this is the last time like I get to give something to my little girl, because when we had court earlier this week, her court case is closed, which is really exciting. Yeah, just to reflect a little on how my first case went. The first thing is, this case lasted 2 years. So 2 years ago, come March, I was trained to be a CASA, and it was a lot of training. And soon after, like, I graduated the program in March, and then I was put on a case in May. So it was really, really quick. One reason I decided to become a CASA is I needed something to fill my time. I wasn't working. We had just moved here. Ray was deployed. My mom is a CASA in Texas, and I really like all the work that she's done. And when she ever talked about CASA, I just found it really fascinating and interesting, you know, helping these kids and learning, even just learning and working with people who, families, they need your help. These children need your help. I love working with kids, and that was a really big selling point on becoming a CASA. So CASA works with kids on dependency and neglect cases. Obviously, I can't go into the case, but it was a neglect case. A very sad situation, but in the end, I think everything has worked out in the best interest of the children, because that's what CASA is about, is what is in the best interest. As far as reflecting on things I could have done differently, now, first of all, with COVID, that changed a lot of stuff here past year at this point. I wasn't able to see my kids as much I would like, because there was room in the FAFSA office. We were not allowed to go in person and visit the kids. And having one of my kids who's nonverbal, it's just really hard to do a virtual call with him because he can't really say anything to you. So it's a very rewarding experience. Presents wrapped and I can't wait to go deliver them. Unfortunately, it just has to be like a porch drop up. I just have to leave these gifts on the porch for them, and then I'll let their caregivers know that they have presents waiting for them on the porch. But thank you so much for watching. If you like your results today, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, and please consider subscribing so you can stay up to date on my latest videos right here on Pink and Pug. Until next time, bye.